Wow, really? That's crazy. That was super loud. I like to order my red sauce on the side. Got my paper towels. And now we're ready to eat. So, where do I put this mic? No, I can't put it there. I need something to put this mic on. I hope it's picking up the sound good. So, just to get into a little detail about my order, I normally do a bowl. I've never done anything else. Even though I saw a tweet of the quesadillas that Chipotle just came out with, and those look so good. Like, I definitely think I'm gonna get those the next time. But yeah, I get white rice with black beans, barbacoa, which is steak, guacamole, corn, sour cream, with the red sauce on the side. They gave me a lot this time too. That's a good amount. And I'm ghetto, so I do use this on tacos that I make at home. I'll normally, like, if I'm weird, so if I know I'm gonna get Chipotle, I normally get Chipotle on Friday. I don't know why, but it's like Chipotle Friday in my head. So on Thursdays, I'll buy ground beef. And I'll prep some taco meat, and I'll make taco salad on Thursday. I'll get Chipotle on Friday. I'll save the sauce for Saturday, and then Saturday I'll make real tacos with the sauce on top. Like, that's my order in my head. So, I don't have a hair tie, so... Sometimes it really tastes like the beans are straight out the can. Like, just not the most aesthetically pleasing. Which kind of makes my mind jump to, like, whenever I've, like, are they like, oh, she's eating my, so ugly right now, like, I can barely look. So, any of my former munches, if you've been my munch at any point in time, just comment below. Well, oh, I hope to God you never see this video, but also, when I was it ugly? Like, did it look ugly? Am I your ugliest eater? Former munches, comment down below. Anyway. Dude, this cheese is, like, coagulating at this point. I need to hurry up and eat this and dip this in here. So, I have a few different orders I do at Chipotle, just like everyone else. I told you my order, what it is, but I also have a second order of sofritas, which I probably shouldn't have got sofritas today, but all I had this morning was a bagel and cream cheese and a coffee, so I haven't had anything since, like, 9 in the morning. It's like, I'm not gonna say what time it is, but it's in the afternoon now, and I'm starving. I feel like most people only go to Chipotle when they're absolutely about to pass away from malnutrition. Like, Chipotle is the perfect meal after, like, a bump. You've been at the gym, really getting your gains. You've been getting to the gains real bad, and you're just like, fuck, I need something that is gonna be some good macros, some healthy macros, as soon as possible. Chipotle is definitely the meal for you. Chipotle's definitely a healthier option, because I know they soak this rice and beans in butter. Like, I can taste the butter in the rice. I can never get my rice that I cook at home to taste like the rice at Chipotle. It just will never happen, because I think they're putting so much butter in it. That's the key. The key is the 20 pounds of butter that they're letting it just soak the rice in. And it's interesting, because I was having this exact same thought when I was at Chipotle, and for the first time ever, I saw how they cooked the rice while I was waiting, and they cooked the rice in a tub that's, like, it's literally this big. It's such a big thing of rice. You know there's at least 7 sticks of Kerrygold Irish butter in there. There's probably so much butter. So, let's talk about the corn. Let's talk about Chipotle corn for a second, right? Chipotle corn, it tastes different than like, canned corn. I don't think that they get their corn out of the can. I feel like their corn is fresh. So, with this bite specifically, I'm gonna get some cheese, and now I'm gonna dip this bite into the red sauce, just because I'm feeling froggy, you know? Is it me? Is it me? Or is this red sauce not spicy today? Like, what's really going on? Did we forget the jalapenos? Did we forget the cayenne? Or what did we forget? Because it's not really not anything major, honestly. It's like a mild sauce. It's like a green sauce. Anyway, back to what I was saying. I normally get sofritas when I don't get barbacoa because it's tofu, and sometimes I don't want all that heavy red meat inside me just rotting. I'm sure everyone has heard about colon cancer rates going up in young adults, and I'm definitely paranoid about that because a visionary stream of consciousness, and I have a lot of video ideas coming up. I'm a pretty fast editor. I've edited videos. I edit all my videos through CapCut, but I do minimal editing just because I'm not really doing anything that requires a huge amount of editing. Like, if I drop some food on my shirt, that's gonna get edited out. If there's a helicopter that flies by, the sound is getting edited, but outside of that, I don't really see the need to be doing, like, intensive editing on my videos. All of my videos will probably be filmed right here, as this is the only place where there's, like, good lighting. It should probably be best. kidding if I open this window. Maybe, I don't know. Because I do have the type of neighbors, they will stand outside and just watch you through your window. So I'm trying to, like, not have them completely up. Because mofos be on some weird-ish for some reason. Anyway, that, like, did nothing. But, yeah. I didn't suck down my Diet Coke like within a nanosecond because that would have been real good. I need to start ordering two drinks, one for the car and one for the actual meal, because the way I inhaled my Diet Coke when I intended on having it with my meal, it was astronomically fast. Like, don't trust me around Diet Coke. Don't trust me around Diet Coke. Shit. The flavors are melting on my tongue. Like, let's be serious here. This steak, well, here's my thing. When Chipotle's good, it's amazing. When Chipotle's it's the worst thing you've ever had in your life. Like, I would rather have a lean cuisine. Most lean cuisine meals taste better than bad Chipotle. I'll make that statement right here, right now. But today, this Chipotle bowl is going stupid. Like, it's going crazy right now. Like, look at it. Who hasn't filed their taxes yet? Because I definitely haven't. But it's like, it's not like I'm getting any money back, so I don't even know why I said that. I don't get any money back anymore. Jeez. Cheese definitely needs some salt. Like, I think that's the main problem. It's coagulated, like it's cottage cheese, but it also needs salt, like MSG, salt. And I touch my hair a lot because, like, I plan on washing this hair today. Once I wash it, I'll touch it less because it feels so dirty, and everything I'm doing, like, it won't even hold a curl at this point. I don't curl my hair very often, but if I did, it wouldn't hold one. So, I'll touch it less when it's clean. It's just not holding. It's not holding a curl. It's not holding behind my ear. It's not doing anything. In fact, I wish I had some clips. Like, 1 second. I can't eat in this condition. I cannot eat in this condition. I look insane, but that's fine. There's no one's gonna be watching my videos anyway, so it doesn't matter. My biggest fear about starting a YouTube channel is like someone from my past seeing it. But also it's like, until I see the last 4 digits of someone else's debit card on my bills, when that day happens, I should be afraid that day. If someone's paying some bills and I'm like, hey, get rid of this channel's gone, the channel's out, it's dead, it's DOA. But it's my Blue Snowball mic, and it's my MacBook, and it's my Chipotle in my apartment that I drove my car to film. So as long as everything is mine, like the seagulls in Finding Nemo, then I'm good. Doesn't matter. Digital footprint. Never heard of her. I don't know who she is. New show called Shogun, and it's on Hulu. I'm definitely gonna do a best of Hulu video because the only streaming service I pay for is Hulu, and they release new things on it all the time, and a lot of people, they're not sold on Hulu, but I am. So I want to do a best of Hulu series just to let everyone know what is worth watching and what isn't. Based in, like, the show I'm talking about Shogun is based in, like, feudal Japan. But the language they're using, like, their English is Portuguese. So they're speaking Japanese and Portuguese, I believe. So, there's a lot going on, but I'm excited to see it. I just needed to see some reviews before I dove in. Reviews are good. Food digests. I'm gonna go for a power walk. I've been successfully losing weight with walking and calorie maintenance. And I know everybody says that, like, duh, you're probably thinking, yeah, that's gonna happen. But I just need it. I'm on week two at this point with trying to for dessert, this fiber cereal, and then just fast until tomorrow. I'll go on a walk for tomorrow. Tomorrow's Saturday. I'm gonna go on a walk, but, like, I haven't been feeling very well, so it's gonna be a brisk walk. But because I'm so out of shape, this is a life hack. When you're out of shape, this is a life hack for everybody. Everyone within the sound of my voice, you're a hack. Here's what you gotta do, right? Here's what you gotta do. Get really so not used to it at first. So what I did was I got a vet. I became the Michelin man. I got back on the treadmill and I burned fat quickly. Like I was burning, I burn calories like crazy when I'm back on a health journey versus like when I'm on the tail end of my health journey, because 2 years ago, around August of 2022, and I'm going to talk about this in another video, but around August of 2022, I lost 18 pounds. So, June 1st, 2022, I was 100 and, mid-160s, I was like 165 by August of 2022, so 3 months later, I was 148 pounds. So, I did that specifically. I didn't, there was no Ozempic for people who were not diabetic at that time. The only thing I did was I burned about 600 calories a day. And that was after working all day. And I was an office assistant at the time. I'm an office manager at another job now, but when I was an office assistant, you're doing everything that the office manager isn't doing. So you're running up and down steps, you're dropping things off, you're taking packages here, taking packages there, you're taking packages to your car, you're walking everywhere. So after I was walking all day, I would go home, and I would get my fanny pack, my water bottle, my hat. I'd walk to the apartment complex across the street, and I would use their treadmills because the ones here never work. And I'd hop on the treadmill I'd be on there for at least 80 minutes. And I did that diligently, consistently, all June and July. I started June 1st. All June and July. I did it every single day. Well, not every single. I worked out 6 days a week, every single week, until August. And then, August, like, 5th of 2022, I got COVID, and I didn't have the type of COVID where you can go play basketball and then with a slight cough and be fine. Otherwise, the COVID I had was debilitating. I have never been that sick in my life. And what's crazy about that COVID I had is I was a pillar. I was a pillar, a bill of health. Whatever it's called, I was always extremely healthy. I have had more sicknesses after that COVID than I've had my entire life, and I'm not a conspiracy theorist at all. But it does raise a question of, I think COVID hit my immune system in a way it's never been hit. It can't be reversed. Like, I have a stuffy nose right now just because I'm having red Chipotle salsa. Like, how is that possible? But it's happening. Like, I will get sick like this. It's insane. Yeah, it's insane. But I said all that to say, like, I brought that up because the COVID boosted my weight loss in a way that wouldn't have happened otherwise, because I didn't eat for 3 days straight. I could not leave my bed for 2 days. I didn't have a drop of food. I didn't have any water. I didn't have an insurer. I didn't have a Weight Watcher shake. I didn't have a thing. I was stuck in bed until my fever broke. My fever broke on the third day. And on the third day, I was feeling peckish. But when I tried to eat some eggs, I immediately threw up. And honestly, eggs probably was a dumb idea because eggs make me nauseous and want to vomit when I don't have COVID. So I don't know why eggs was a smart idea when I did have COVID. But then I went another 24 hours without any food in that 3 days of no food. I lost like 5 pounds. Now I see why anorexics are so addicted to that feeling of not having, of being skinny, because literally the only thing outside of diet and exercise that's gonna get you skinny quick is just not having any food at all. So. August of 2022. I was 148 pounds. Fast forward to March. Today's March 1st, 2024. I'm 160 pounds. So I've gained 12 pounds back. My sweet spot is 145. That's my sweet spot because I look skinny in photos. I feel thin. I feel healthy when I look in the mirror. And I'm officially at that weight. I am officially a tried and true size 4. So when I am a tried and true size 4, I can walk into any store I want, buy a size 4, not try it on, and know 100% that it's going to fit. Now, when I go to the store, I have to return probably 60% of what I buy. Because I know it's not going to fit. It's just not, even if it's a medium. My butt is plump. It's not big. It's not like I don't have a King Kylie back there. I don't have a Nikki back there. And I definitely don't have a Jessica Dime, okay? But I'm working with a little something. I'm gonna try to true size 4, but also I want this time around, I want to also include weight training because I remember how my butt looked when I was 148 pounds. It was as droopy. It was as droopy as this queso. It was globbity. It was coagulated just like this queso. You know, Paris Hilton said that Kim Kardashian ass look like cottage cheese in a trash bag. That's exactly how mine looked. So not only do we need to focus on slimming down, we need to focus on maintaining muscle so we can keep things high and tight. I don't know why I brought any of that up. Like, that had nothing to do with the Chipotle. But, yeah. I'm going on a walk after I eat this. The weather today is so pretty. Like, it is, what's my watch say? 67 degrees with a high of 69. So, you're a criminal if you don't take a walk when it's 69 degrees out. I'm just saying. It's making me eat slower because if I was not recording myself eating this Chipotle, this whole thing would have been gone. The entire thing would have been gone in like literally 15 minutes. I'm at 42 minutes right now and it's half full, so maybe I should record all my meals so I don't just wolf it down. Still, if I continue to do the 1.5 pounds a week, time I want to travel, which is probably like in August, September, October. My birthday's in October, and I definitely don't want to be in this country. I should be like, if I was like continuing to be in a deficit, I should be way less than 145 for sure. But I'll do that math later. I should have got a spoon. I need something that's more of a shovel. Shovel shaped. I already said this like 10 minutes into the video, but I think it'd be fun to do an ASMR get ready with me. That'd be pretty fun. I've never done my makeup at this table before. Like, so that'll be a first. That cheese is actually good today. I don't know what they do. I don't know if they fired their old staff or what, but like, I always go to that exact same Chipotle, and this is so good today. Like, it's insane how good this is. Like, the beans are cooked today. They cooked the black beans today. Like, I don't know if the health inspector paid a visit before I came in or what, but everything is tasting like it needs to be finally. I cannot wait until I get my first hate comment. I'm definitely gonna do a video that's like, read my hate comments with me, because that shit would be so funny to me. Oh my god. But that doesn't mean leave me a hate comment. I'm not. I don't want to see them, but if it happens to happen, if someone happens to leave a comment, that's distasteful. It's obviously gonna be funny, but also like, don't do that. Save me some money, please. Please and thank you. But I only have one tattoo. And I was such a punk. Like, it was supposed to be four of these. Kind of like north, south, east, and west of this one here. The exact same of this. But four like that. And then I was going to do something in the middle. But like, this first one hurt so bad that she was like, okay, well, you seem to be flinching a lot. And I like to meet my clients' needs. So if you need more time, you can come back and get it finished. And we'll do it whenever you see fit. Well, that was April of 2022. So it's literally 2 years later and I have not been back. But what's funny is I've been back to that same tattoo shop to get my ears pierced twice. But not to get tattooed again. I just don't know if I can do it. Like, I don't understand how people are tattooed on their head, their ribs, their neck. Like, it burned. It was like a burn I've never experienced. And one of my friends told me, well, next time you need to buy some lidocaine. So I bought lidocaine 5%. But I've tested it multiple times. It wears off in like less than 30 minutes. So if I'm getting like a full back piece, I'm gonna have to, well, I would never get a full back piece, but there is a tattoo idea that I have of this like beautiful ancient, it's like an ancient Rococo time period and art of a fan. It's like a fan you fan with, but it's like this, and it has like a full Rococo kind of painting inside the fan, and I wanted it like tattooed on my back. But the pain that this that I had with that, I don't even know. Like, I don't think I could do it. I would need to be put under anesthesia, like Dak Prescott when he got his leg tattoo. Options, why would we not take that option? I'm so confused. It's the same thing with winning. The pain Olympics is childish, honestly. We've reached the last bite. since this bite is so special, I will be dipping the cheese and the red sauce. I'm definitely glad that I was given the opportunity to make this purchase and go home and eat this all by myself. And I'm glad I didn't get chips because chips would have overdid it. And their chips are so sour. Like, did someone piss on these? It's like when skunk sprays that juice. It's like skunk juice was sprayed all over the batch. And they just put some salt on it and say, "Bon appetit. Bone apple tea." Last swig of water as well. I love when everything I was eating and consuming finishes at the same time. Like, it's the equivalent of your shampoo and conditioner being done the same day. Excuse me, that was not ladylike at all. It's like all falling all down. Okay, anyway. Eat that food. I feel like I just got home. But if you made it to the end, thank you so much. If you are asleep, also thank you as well for watching. Well, obviously thank both for watching, but if you made it to the end, really thank you for watching. If you're asleep, get to Starbucks before you get to work, because that's a real good day when you made it out the Starbucks queue without the line wrapped around the street. You're doing good and you get to work on time. You had a good day that day. Anyway.